With many of the common mid champs getting nerfed in the upcoming patches, do I think Lux might make a comeback in the competitive scene? I actually think Lux is fairly good right now. All it really takes is one player to have a preference for a champion and to play them consistently, and you'll start to see them like break into the competitive scene. So, like, an example, I guess, right now would be this is like one that I'm involved in, so it's just easy for me to like remember or recall easily. But like, for example, Katarina, I think I was probably the only person that was willing to play Katarina competitively, at least in NA. And I just started playing her in scrims, like, over the course of many months while we were in relegations and stuff. And then, eventually, all the people that thought Katarina wasn't viable started playing her again, too. And she's just sort of making somewhat of a comeback. So, I think that, I'm talking strictly in competitive play. So, there's a lot of examples like that where you can see people picking up champions that were untouched for a long time and just looking pretty strong with them. But yeah, on Yasuo mid, I'm gonna go, I think I'm versus Kat. That's actually not that great of a matchup in my opinion. Kat can rush early armor, and her all-in is not really projectile-based, so she has a lot of ways to outplay you, but it's a skill matchup at the core. But yeah, just standard Yasuo page, a few crit runes, 2 lifesteal quints, 1 AD quint, the rest 80 reds, armor yellows, MR blues, and then 21 offense, spell weaving, executioner, dangerous game, blade weaving, Devastating Strikes, 1 point Warlord, no points in Warlord, Havoc, and then 9 points in this. I actually think I missed a point. Oh, never mind. Normally you can get this. I think I did something. Oh, I put too many points here. Alright, whatever. 21-9 is pretty standard in Yasuo. I just use that setup. And let's see. Loading into the game right now. Yeah, I was sure it was going to be TNC on Katarina. Don't know anyone on the team besides Altec. Hopefully our bot lane's pretty good, otherwise Altec might cause some problems this game. String for about just a little bit less than an hour. I tried turning on my stream and then it was like bugging out, and I think a lot of people were annoyed by that, but I fixed the problem for now, I believe, so hopefully it doesn't come back. I do know how to speak Farsi. I learned it when I was a kid and spoke with my parents and like my family a lot, so pretty fluent. I don't speak it obviously here, so I'm a bit rusty, but if I started speaking a little bit more, I think I'd quickly become adjusted to using it more. I'm in my place of matches right now. I'm 1-1. Last game seemed like we were winning, but then it basically turned into like one of the craziest games ever. So I don't really care where I get in placement. I just want to play solo queue and have some fun games. But pretty cool that the ladder reset. Can start ranking up again and try to go for the new era of challengers and stuff like that. What do I think about the new Riven? I think Riven got nerfed fairly decently. I'm not sure if she'll be playing competitively. At least not with such constant pick bans and stuff like that after the changes. But I don't think she's crippled or anything like that. She's just not as strong. So you'll probably see people who are like really good at Riven still pick her in the situations that they think are valid. And then if they're not, then like the bandwagoners probably won't be playing her as much. What? Oh, wait, let me see. Is it like the popcorn one? Oh, yeah, those are pretty good. Thank you. But yeah, I think I did say that. Wanderer isn't always lost. Yeah, wait, you got them too? Oh, you got it for yourself?
Anything.
Wait, you do? Thanks, guys.
Justice. That's a pretty word.
Do, 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 do. Wait, what are they pinging? I think they're just messing with me. Alright. Wait, can you guys not see me at all? Yeah, it's pretty bad. It's like super dark. Maybe I'll fix it later. Alright, so I'm versus Katarina mid. Start with my Q. She has Duran's shield. Duran's shield is actually quite a good start versus Yo because it mitigates not only your auto attack damage, but your Q damage, since your Q is coded as an auto attack, and it basically performs as one in every scenario. It life steals, it crits, scales off attack speed, all that good stuff. Damn, she got 2 CS with that Q. She's even on CS with me. Just gonna walk up and Q her, and it also draws creep aggro, whereas abilities normally don't. It's a little bit annoying, but not the end of the world. I'm gonna try hit level 2 here. I think I crit him once there. The Q's charged up. I'm gonna just Q here because he has to go for the CS. Well, he doesn't have to, but it's pretty predictable. And what's their jungler? Nocturne. So early game Nocturne ganks could be a little just tricky. I'm gonna try to get this guy low enough so if Nocturne tries to gank me, they won't be able to kill me, but I'm not sure if that's possible. Katarina hit 3. She got Shenpo, but she didn't want to use it on me. Since Nocturne wasn't in range to get CC off, the actual potential to kill me there was not too hot, I think. Hearing him, don't want to dash onto him. Could dash there, but it's not that big a deal. Yeah, I missed. Slightly out of range. He started backing off. Charging up my Q. I got the knock up soon. Tried to hit him with that. It was a CS at 13. Not bad. Gangplank is high health. We can probably die this guy. I guess she doesn't want to. Oh, I take a turret shot. No. I'm trying to get this is the area he ganked from before. Mostly mid laners won't call out where they ward, so a lot of times junglers will just go exactly where you ward and try ganking anyway. Damn, he dodged it. That was pretty slick. I should have just dashed a creep there, so I still had an opportunity to dash him again. But I could have got the knockup off, just not the E damage there. Mm-hmm. Playing this lane like this is actually not bad, because Katarina is good at lasting her turret, but she will miss some. And can still get quite a bit of her ass off here. Follow the wind. Got him with that. He's gonna go for this one, I think. Oh, he just let it go. So I have a 14 CS advantage right now, and I'm just chunking him down. He's always at a lower health differential than me. And if he ever messes up or I get my ult or something and get a knockup, I can just all in him and get a kill, so. Get some decent damage off there. Let's charge up my Q here. Dash like that. Just messing with him. Don't intend to dive him. But he's not getting any of this farm because he dashed onto the creeps like that. Just building my CS lead and chunking him down all together. I get a knock up on him, I'm gonna go. I think. Damn, I didn't get the key chart. Just messing with them. He could have feared me there, but chose not to. And I was more than okay with him fearing me. I don't think they had much way of killing me there. My honor left a long time ago. I wonder if he's gonna try to ult onto me. He's actually not that low right now, so gotta be careful. Damn, he's so scared to walk up. 25 CS lead. Okay, he lagged there.
Something's never dull.
Oh, he just... Oh yeah, what's he doing? Maybe he DC'd. I'm just gonna leave the lane. Okay, he DC'd completely. That's unfortunate.
Never could stay in one place.
Guess I'll go look for a play top. I don't want to push him top. I want to push him mid in case he comes back soon, so that way he can still get these CS. And I still have the opportunity to do something productive with my time by looking for a roam top here. Not gonna just flash. Go get this farm. I'm just gonna time his flash. Oops, I missed. Teemo's mid. Well, that doesn't really solve the problem because Teemo's pushing it out right now. But I guess I'll just push this in and then go back to buy. Just gonna back here. This is unfortunate. Okay, I got Zeal and my Avarice Blade. So, got a decent amount of crit going. It's pretty good. Okay, he's back.
Honor is in the heart.
Not fun for Cat here. Wonder if Teemo's gonna bully him hard. Oh, it looks like it. I think he maxed E though, so Cat's not gonna have the worst time. If he maxed Q, then he'd be able to crush her with the sight level and farm advantage and such. Just gonna ult him for fun. Way too hard there, and I missed my Q. I could be like full health, and he could be like the exact same health he is if I didn't go for that last Q. He maxed his oranges here. Not sure. I think I can win while his Q. As long as I'm watching out for it.
It is not yet time.
Keep pushing him in. He's pretty low on mana. Not sure what his response is gonna be. Let's just be backing. I have a. Wait, I had a knockup, but I didn't realize. Could easily knock him up. If I got the knockup, I would have just flashed over and finished him off. I was not really paying attention because I usually look at my character, but since the knockner ult was down, I was just like confused. It was too dark. That's my excuse, Pete. Alright, Static Shiv is completed. That's going to be a really nice farm and damage potential. Farming ability and damage potential, and I think I'm going to get a pickaxe. Just work towards IE next. That's all I can afford anyway. Could also got a Cloak of Agility and a bunch of pots and stuff, but it was not too. Wait, this is called Static Shank? I didn't know that. It's pretty funny. Passive effect, not the item, obviously.
I alone decide my fate.
Oh, I missed. It was a little bit scared, so I just flashed. If you walked into it and I got the ult off, that would've been funny. I'm gonna back here. Too low. Me and I'll take trade flashes. Wait, they lost? Yeah, surprising. I thought Altair was gonna crush our bot lane. They might be doing or something. I actually don't know Carlotta. Maybe he's an experienced AD. I just assume the worst for the promotion matches. I just feel like there's like mismatches of skill, but it's actually not that different. Like, they try to get you with teammates that are relatively close in MMR. Obviously not everyone's gonna be the same rank or anything, but it's not like Bronze is playing with Diamond ones and Challenge and stuff. Makes a little bit more sense than that. Alright, I'm actually gonna... okay. Head down here. Oh. Trying to build my thing. Live! I wonder if that blocks. I don't think it does. It's definitely not a projectile. Build up my Q here. See if I can get a knock up on someone. Nope. Almost have 1550 for BF sword. That'd be good. Actually, almost level 11 too. Oh yeah, on this patch, Yusuo's ult gives him shield too. Forgot about that. Oh, I'm dead. Boy, I'm so bad. I just dashed into three people. I only saw ult tech. I was like, oh, I'll just ult in him. Try to build my ult on the creep wave and then go for the one shot. Then three behind. And then I just saw the Nocturne, the Leona right behind him. Getting early Zerkers is actually pretty valuable on Yusuo because you can move around the map really fast with high base MS, and it, you build your float easier, and your Q and stuff scale off attack speed, so it's actually a really good idea to get early Zerkers if you don't need mercs for the enemy to counteract the enemy team comp. But since every time I backed, I only had enough gold for like a pickaxe, and just now I only had enough for BF sword, I just never really found an opportunity to slip in an efficient source of Zerker, an efficient spot for Zerker's greaves. Which is perfectly fine, but I'm just noting that in different circumstances, it's like not bad to get earlier. You don't have to skip boots or anything. It's actually probably preferred to get Zerkers after you finish Static Shift. But Static Shift is probably the best item, so if you can, you want to rush it, in my opinion. Just gonna ult. He's dead. Chain has made his Q feel, his EQ combo feel pretty smooth.
Follow the wind.
Blue buff is actually terrible on Yusuo, if I don't want it. Just let Annie take it. The reason it's terrible is his Q scales only on attack speed, not CDR, and his E doesn't even scale with CDR. The speed of your E actually scales with the bonus MS that you have. But nothing else. Mm. I came up right as he was falling from my Q knockup, so I wasn't able to chain the ults. Or chain my ult. Right back. Pretty low. No. Yeah, I'm fine. Kat was already behind from lane, and then she fell really far behind after DCing to the point where she wasn't able to come back, which is pretty unfortunate, but I don't think they were going to have a huge chance of winning the game regardless. I'm going to get Dagger. Actually, no. Let's refund and get Boots. This should be fine. I had mid. Now that I have IE and Sag Shiv combined with my runes, I have 100% crit rate because you see those passive doubles as crit chance. So my Q will always crit, my EQ combo will always crit, and of course my auto attacks will always crit, which is really, really strong. Usually this is like your core items on Yasuo. Next up, either BT or Last Whisper, depending on how the enemy team is built. If they don't really have, what the heck is this like triangle thing? Or X. So weird. Shut down. Wait, yeah, it's a cross, I guess. I went into that knowing I was outnumbered, but I went in to take out the Nocturne, and they used a little bit on me, but as you can see, his shield still melts pretty fast with just damage items. His flow gives him a lot of extra survivability. Like, as you saw there, when I popped my ult, I actually lived a bit longer than you expect based on the health I was at. It's because I got the extra 240 shield from using my last breath, and I ended up surviving just long enough to get that last Kuron Nocturne and kill him, but it was pretty sketchy, to be honest. But yeah, anyway, if the enemy team is not building much armor and you want to go for a damage item, then BT's next is really good because the extra AD scales so well with your ridiculous crit chance. And the extra life steal makes you super tanky in team fights and stuff. You can just constantly proc that crit plus life steal combo. If they have a lot of armor, then Last Whisper next is good. And if you need a defensive item, then I really like GA. I've been randomly getting points in Windwall, not for any particular reason. I should be maxing E completely. Like, right now, I should have maxed out E. The cooldown should be 0.1 seconds, and just be ready to go off with it. But I didn't do any of these things. Win while this thing. Just in their base. Nocturne the owner up. You can get in up here. Oh, I died too fast. I'm trying to get the knockup into my ult. I want to kill them and try to get the inhib. Oh, no, Leandre's. Oh, kill them. Did he have ignite on them or something? That's weird. I have no idea why I put points in W. I think I was just mindlessly doing it. I assumed my E was already maxed, but I was not paying any attention. But yeah, anyway, you never want to get points in W. You just want to put 1 point, so 1 point wonder. Max their Q, max their E for the most part. Maxing E first is actually not terrible, but Q is just super solid. But yeah, you can max E first too. Both are perfectly acceptable in my opinion. Although I think the standard is definitely Q max. Right here, I'm actually gonna sell my ward and get a BF sword. I could have waited for 10 seconds, but I don't want to wait that long. Just go grab red. I think I turned slow mode off for subs. I'm not sure though. I think I did in the settings. The sword's poor company for it was by request. Why should I just try 1v5 without defensive items? Oh, I can get my Q into R combo. Rampage.
Kill him, Teemo. It's all you. Got them all, baby. He's on a rampage. Nice. The Penta! Give it to him! Walk into the shrimp. Dang, that would have been hilarious if we gave him the Penta by walking into the shroom. Oh well. Let's see. He got bot turret. I need some defensive items here, so their team is almost all AD except for Katarina. Therefore, a chain vest here is definitely appropriate. And since I'm getting high levels, getting resist at this point is really valuable, because when he still gets high levels, his shield strength increases dramatically. At level 14, it's 350. At level 18, it goes up to 690, so it almost doubles at that point, with just 4 extra levels. And so when you get to late game Yasuo, you definitely want to make sure you have some resist, just because you can get so tanky with just a few defensive items. Like a G8, honestly, is more than enough, usually. I think I'm just going to sit on chain vest and then go BT. Oh, crud. Coming. I think they're not going to try to turn this. They're pretty smart. Oh. Wait, what's happening? I could just run in and die. Why is that cross still there? I'm just going to walk into them. Oh, God, what have I done? I did okay damage, but I just died for no reason. I didn't expect them to aim for me, but they had a pink there, so they knew I was coming. I thought they'd be scareder. That's my bad. I think when I have, like, a little bit more, yep, just sell this and get Vamp Scepter. I only have the 4% lifesteal I had from runes. Now I bought a Vamp Scepter, so I have 14%. So the extra the amount of damage I'm doing, which is with the 100% crit rate, I'm gonna be able to lifesteal off 14% of that every time. And it also, you can also lifesteal off your Q. So getting the extra lifesteal here and then working towards the Bloodthirster is actually really good. But yeah, we've just been kind of trolling around and messing, and not really trying to win this game. I've just been like running into like 5 people and trying to do stuff, but that's probably not the best way to close out the game. And since we like threw the last game, sorta, probably should just try to win this one without playing too silly. I can see them somehow coming back. We gotta be careful. I'm gonna go split push bot right now. Our jungle Rengar actually is splitting too. He's got decent amount of items. He just wanted the wave. I was saying we could have done like a secret agent mission together. They would never have seen it coming. I got the knockup, but I'm not gonna use on Leona. Coming mid. Alright, there you go. Close it out. I made the P face at alt deck. Oh, I typed G twice. I thought I didn't type it. I just instinctively typed after I made the P face.